Section 4.2, digital state sets. Now, when you're working with digital tags, you're working with a tag that's in fact stored as an integer, but we display the data as text. Any guesses as to why we do this? Well, it is really simple. It's a lot cheaper in terms of resources to store things as integers than to store them as strings of text. So if you can build yourself a little lookup table to point yourself to the text, and then store this as an integer, it just takes a lot less space, it's a lot faster for retrieval, etc. The point type here is going to be a digital. Here's an example of a digital tag. If we take a look at the tag CDM158, here are the different values. Now, in fact, these are a finite set of values, and there's only five in this case. And in point of fact, we're not storing these as these words here. We're storing this as a number 0 through 4. So that's what a digital is, and it's not just on, off, open, close. It can be any number of digital states in this digital state sets. So these digital tags, they do have an associated digital set. We use the attribute called digital set to associate a tag with a digital set name. And that digital set obviously has to exist prior to the creation of the digital tag that uses that set. So here's some examples of some digital state sets. Here's a my set, which has five states, and these five states are manual through failed. So in fact, if we were to look at this internally, this would be represented in the archive as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Now, here's a real straightforward one, my set 2, 0 for on, 1 for off. Actually, it's more typically the other way around, 0 for off, 1 for on. But as you can see, if you need that, you can create another set that would define it that way. Here's a third set, my set 3. This would be 0, 1, and 2. Now, you may notice that sometimes, let me go back here, sometimes digital tags are going to have a dummy digital state at the beginning, because sometimes we're not getting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're actually getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from the data source. So in that case, what you end up having to create, let me go back here again, you end up having to create a digital state set with a kind of a dummy in the first instance. So this might be just a dash, and then we start manual, auto, cascade, etc. like that. Also, you should know that digital state sets, they are case insensitive, but they are case preserving. So whatever case you enter when you first create that that digital state, that's the case that you're going to be stuck with for quite a while. So now there are some ways to fix that through PyConfig, but yeah, it's a kind of an odd combination. It's case preserving but case insensitive. So for example, if you look at a digital state such as program, if we had first done that as a lowercase p, then actually we're going to preserve that, and we would have to go in and use PyConfig with some special scripts that we have documented elsewhere to change the case of that if we want to later on. So it's a very minor point, but it's something to keep in mind. Now I'm going to take a look at the digital state database from within the Py System Management tools. So if you go within points and digital states, this is where you'll see the different states that we ship with the system. For example, the one we were just looking at, modes, you know, here are those states, 0 through 4. Now, there's a very interesting digital state set called system. And system is where we keep all those things that are, well, that are used by the system. So, for example, a little earlier today, we saw something called point created. It was a digital state called point created. And if I can remember correctly, that is somewhere down here. Yeah, point created is just a digital state in the sample digital state set. Or excuse me, in the system digital state set. Yeah, there it is right there. I'm sorry, I clicked on that and it went back to the beginning here. Let me find that again. Yeah, here it is right here, this point created. So point created is simply an item within that digital state set called system. Now that's something obviously we suggest that you don't edit. That's the system digital state set.